Oh, man. I'm nervous because it was such an investment.
Well, it's going to be great, babe. And I'll be moving to you. Come on,
okay,
get to the good stuff.
Calm down. I want to open this properly.
It's good though.
Oh my God, they're heavy. Yeah, the center spreads look great. Wow. The print quality is like, it's way better than I thought. You centered the pages perfectly. I mean, look at it. They're like, it's like just opening my journal.
Pretty cool, huh?
That's so cool. They look great. The journal spreads look awesome. Oh, I love the baddies on the back. I love the way the cover feels. Oh my God, this is awesome.
You happy?
Yes, I'm so happy. Oh my God. That's so exciting. YouTube. I realized I've been vlogging for almost two full days and have not once actually talked to the camera yet, which is really weird. I think I've just been like really in the zone, I think. The past 2 days have been insanely productive, as you have seen. Just doing all sorts of things. Mainly prepping for the Book of Bun, which arrived much earlier than I thought it was going to show up. The printer that I got it done from did an amazing job. So yeah, it showed up, my copies of it. It looks amazing. I'm very pleased with it. More to come on all of that. I will be doing a separate like video tour kind of thing about like with it. I have an idea. I don't wanna go too much into it, but I have a video that next week I'll be working on to kind of talk about it and release all the information of when it's gonna come out and all that stuff. But I'm hoping to launch it within the next week or two. That's the goal, so we'll see. But there's a lot of prep work leading up to launching an item like this. As you've seen, I'm literally painting like tons of envelopes and stamping return addresses and just prepping the packaging because it's gonna have its own packaging that's different from some of my other stuff that I sell in my Etsy shop. All that just takes time and work and figuring it out. And although my mom is gonna be coming to help me next week, this is like my biggest launch of something that I've done, especially like quantity wise. So I'm trying to really just get a head start and chip away at things now. And to be honest, I'm kind of enjoying it. Like just kind of doing like monotonous, repetitive kind of work is kind of relaxing right now, so I'm kind of just embracing that. But in between that, I've been streaming on Twitch, working on my sketchbook. I've started some new zines, like new mini zines that I'm really excited about. Been working on the illustrations for that. So yeah, this past week has just been really productive, and the new Art Snacks video came out. Totally forgot about that. That was earlier this week. Oh my gosh, it's like such a blur. So yeah, it's just been a really awesome, productive week, and I'm happy about that. I'm getting ready to go out right now because it is our friend's birthday. Hollis, if you watch the vlogs, I don't think she does, but happy birthday. She's in our D&D crew, so we are meeting up with her and some friends at a bar tonight. So that's what's going on. I'm not sure if I'll take you with me. So this vlog will either continue tomorrow morning. I have no idea. So yeah, just get myself dressed up. That's what's going on.
They both put themselves in this position. I need to get up and eat. They piled in. Look at this. And Booba's just extra cute.
Well, it has been several days later. Today is February 15th, and I realized I didn't really film like an outro to this vlog. I didn't really talk to the camera a lot, so I thought that I would film a little outro and share some of your amazing mail that you guys have sent to my P.O. Box. I have not shared P.O. Box mail in a long time, and I have so much incredible stuff from you guys. So I think it is now time for mail time. I'm looking extra haggard at the moment. My mom is on her way here right now to help me with more packaging and Book of Bun stuff, which is awesome. I'm also gonna be helping her with a project. But right now I thought it'd be good to open up some of the amazing P.O. Box mail. I mean, I have like a pile in front of me here. I also have a huge pile in the back of my studio that I just have been kind of saving to reveal on camera. So I'm doing my best to try to show everything that I get from you guys. Smaller stuff, I might have kind of opened, well, everything I open already because I'm a small child and I can't wait. But some stuff I might have kind of already opened if I got it a long time ago. So just know that even though I'm not maybe showing it on camera, I am so, so, so grateful for everything you guys send me. And you never ever have to send me anything, but the cards, letters, stuff from my wish list is just amazing. And it literally makes my day. I mean, that's why I open everything, because I get it from the post office and then I immediately open it in my car because it's like Christmas, even though I hate Christmas. So maybe I should say it's like Halloween. It's the best thing ever. Mail time. Let's get to it. I'm gonna try to get through a couple of things here. First box, I'm just going with this big one that's right in front of me. Gonna try not to show addresses here. This is from Jay Ray. This came all the way from Canada. I actually received this at Christmas time, so like end of December. So it's actually been, it's been a bit here. Came in this beautiful box. We got the little card inside here with a little thank you note. Dear Roxanne, thank you for all the incredible content and great videos you turn out over the internet. Have bought classes and just purchased from your Black Friday sale. Okay, so yeah, I got this factored a long time ago. Love your podcast vlogs and I'm truly a Crute Corner gal. Oh, I love that. I know you hate Christmas as much as I do, so when I saw this set of ugly PJs, I had to get them for you. Appropriate, don't you think? Anyway, again, thanks for all you do. James, the pugs, and you, you rock. And it is from Joy Ray. Joy, thank you so much for this wonderful note. By the way, you guys, I save all these. I've now created like a book and I organize them all into a book. So I save every little bit of things that you guys send me. So included was this awesome little like metal bunny. It kind of feels like a little paperweight. I've actually been getting like bunnies and I have kind of like my own little collection of buns. So I'm kind of thinking of maybe like this shelf that's back here, turning it into like a shelf of bunnies maybe. I don't know, because it's kind of fun. There's a really cool stash of ephemera in here, which is awesome. Oh, oh, this is the set of pajamas. Now, I did take a peek of these earlier. Oh my God. Bah humbug. I am not a fan of Christmas, but dang, this is actually pretty cute. And it comes with matching pants. Look at those pants. Oh my God. Very cool. Joy, thank you so much for your very generous and super sweet package. Thank you. Okay, next up we have a really cool handmade envelope. Love this. You guys are always so creative with your envelopes and your packaging. Came from, and I'm so sorry if I'm pronouncing your name wrong, Abhaya Thomas from Portland, Oregon. It's actually been such a long time since I've opened these. It's like kind of like opening them new again. Inside was this awesome handmade card. Look at the cover of that. That is so freaking cool. And wow, your handwriting is amazing. Wow. San, thank you for your posts. They are calming and inspirational. I don't really even like spooky so much. And look what came out. All the best, Abaya. I'm so sorry for pronouncing your name wrong. Thank you so much for this. I really, really appreciate it. The handmade cards are like the most fun thing to get. It is so cool. Next was something that I already opened up, and I don't even have the packaging left because I just ripped into it. Again, I am a small child. And it was a set of pens. It was the Graphic Line Maker drawing pens that was on my Amazon wish list, but I've been using them. They're these guys, the Graphics paint liner pens. Kinetic Radio sent me a pack of them. So thank you so much, Vero S at Kinetic Radio. So thank you so much for that. I'm already using them. I already ripped into them. They're getting put to use. Next up, we have another postcard. This is from Sarah G. Sarah is so awesome. She sends me her handmade postcards all the time. And this is what it looks like. It's always super detailed and just delightful how much time she puts into these. So I have a really cool little collection growing. Hey Roxanne, just a note to tell you how much I love your new zine pools. So yeah, I got this a long time ago. I've been loving all the vlogs and podcasts. Can't wait to hear, learn about your new online class. Wink, wink. Haha, new online class is already out. Hallowed Ground, available now. Best to both you and the puggies. XO Sarah G. Thanks so much, Sarah, for the happy mail. You always make my inbox very happy. This was something I got more recently, actually. I picked this up in January. This is from Sharon Bennett, who sent me this really cute little box. And of course I was immediately like, what's in a box of this size? I don't know. So the inside had some tissue paper and a little note. Hi Roxanne, saw these and knew you must have them. Hoping to see you in San Jose in class in August. Much love to you, the pugs, and James. Sharon sent me these amazing bone pens. They're like all different types of bones with the pen tips at the bottom. So cool. I've been itching to use these. And it's actually really appropriate for our Oscar party. We are doing a Dia de los Muertos theme, which is that was the little pins you saw me make earlier in the vlog. So these are gonna be great to use during the party as people are filling out their ballots and stuff. It's totally appropriate. Thank you, Sharon. That is so sweet of you. Thank you so much. I'm really trying to crank. You guys have sent me a lot of stuff. Okay, so someone sent me something else off my Amazon wish list and I already tore into it. This was from Gail. Roxanne, I would love to have gotten you something bigger, but wanted to just send a little token of my appreciation for your work. I love your art. I follow it religiously, and Pug Party is a commute lifesaver. Thank you so much for sending me this. And what was on my wish list was these Le Pen pens. They're like a really colorful fine liner pen. I use them very often. You can see there's some already pulled out of the pack that I use for other stuff. Love them. Thank you so much, Gail, for sending that to me. Again, you guys don't have to send me stuff, but it is so, so awesome. And especially art supplies like this, I am using them. So thank you very, very much. Okay, next up, this comes from Lisa Stockel. And I love the detail she always puts on her packaging. She will like embroider the edges of things. And she, again, is someone else who always makes my inbox very happy. And she sent me a really cool custom little notebook that she made on the outside, and then it's got the blank pages on the inside there. And this was for New Year. She also included a little note, Happy New Year, Lisa. What I'm gonna use this for probably is for when I'm streaming. I always have to take down like quick notes for things, like things I need to fix for the next stream or like my running to-do list. So I think that's what I'm gonna use this for, is like my Twitch streaming to-do list notebook. So thank you, Lisa. As always, you rock. Okay, next up, we have a really cool envelope. Again, you guys, with the packaging is just amazing. This is clearly a handmade envelope of some sort. So this came from Natalie, who included her address on the note on the back, so I can't show you that. But it looks like she made an artist trading card and sent it to me. Really, really sweet. I love the black and white edges there. So cool. Natalie, thank you so much for sending me an artist trading card. I will be saving this. So thank you so much. Okay, next up we have something from Paula and the Pencils, all the way in England. Super fun packaging. The cover and like the doodles on it. I just love that. Look at how cute this washi tape is. Oh, I know what this is. I did rip into this, and this is why. Because I am gonna be framing something that is in here. So Paula made this illustration of Olive, one of our pugs, and I absolutely loved it and like commented, and I think I like reposted it or shared it or something. This was a long time ago. And then she decided to send me the original. She like cut it out of her sketchbook and sent it to me, which is amazing because I plan on framing it. So I had pulled the artwork out of it already. So this was the illustration. So sweet. It's Jeeves. It's from a previous vlog where I was feeding her Cheerios. So you could see the little Cheerios and then like her little desperate Cheerio face. It is just so stinking cute. I'm obsessed with it. And you can even see on the back is other artwork from her sketchbook, because that was like what was on the back of the page. But this is just so special. James and I freaking love this. So in there she also had this rose lemonade infusion tea thing, these really cute little transfers, and then a really sweet little note, again on a little artist trading card. So cool. Hey Roxanne, I'm so excited to be sending my little painting across the Atlantic. It's bonkers. I've cut Olive out of my sketchbook so she's rough around the edges, but I know you won't mind. I can't wait to see what you do with her. Again, I'm framing her. She's gonna be up in my apartment. Love it so much. Lots of love from England, Paula. Paula, thank you for cutting that out of your sketchbook. I really, really appreciate it and absolutely love your work. Moving right along at a very fast pace here because I'm trying to get as much in here as possible. So this was something sent to me actually by a company. A company reached out to me and was like, hey, do you want to try our product? And I was like, sure, okay. And the company is called Carbon Cocoa. So some of you guys might have seen there's a bit of a trend kind of going around with whitening your teeth with natural charcoal. So it's something that I've always wanted to try and I've been very curious about. This is not sponsored by any means, by the way, but they sent me a teeth whitening kit, and I guess there's actual, like, it comes with charcoal toothpaste and like a toothbrush and a whole bunch of other things. It's actually really impressive, the packaging already. I fully intend on using this. I'm gonna open it up and test it and taste it and see how it goes. Let me know if you're intrigued by this as much as I am. I think it's like literally you brush and it like turns your mouth black, I think, which is kind of cool but also a little scary. I have no idea, but I'm definitely gonna give this a try. Let me know if you guys want updates and I will keep you updated here on the vlog. But yeah, this came from Carbon Cocoa. I'm impressed already with the packaging. Okay, next up is a mystery package. This came from Amazon, but there was no note inside, so I have no idea who sent it to me. If you sent this to me, please let me know in the comments below, because I genuinely don't know. There was no note, but it's a really cute pug t-shirt and it's pugs doing yoga. So freaking cute, and it's like a soft shirt too. So I was like thoroughly surprised when I received this, but again, I have no idea who this is from. Let me know in the comments, and thank you so much. It was such a thoughtful and really sweet little gift. This next one was something that I got actually a long time ago, but I've been saving it because I thought it was so cool, like what she sent me. All this came from Lizbeth, and she sent me basically this amazing bundle of like ephemera and stuff. It was wrapped up in this really cool tissue and like yarn, and it had like a little cool tag on the front. So yeah, I just kind of wanted to share some of the goodies in here because, Lizbeth, you've got some amazing eye for ephemera. It is pretty amazing. Inside had a really cool handmade card. I love the handmade cards. Yeah, okay, this is from July 2017. So I have had this for a long time and I'm finally sharing it here. Again, I'm doing my best to save everything and not use it or open stuff up until I have shared it on camera. Okay, so she was actually a student in one of my workshops from a long time ago, and actually I'm gonna be returning back to San Jose and teaching this summer. Enclosed are a few things that I thought you might enjoy. A big what's up to James and hashtag Fruit Corner and Olive and Bear. Well, this is when Bear was still alive. I hope to see you in Northern California again soon, Lizbeth. Thank you so, so much. I might have pulled some things out of here and started using them. I honestly can't remember. So there was a smaller envelope inside that had all sorts of cool like cards. The poison wig is just really cool. We hate you and it's good. Like, these are just so neat. Of course, any kind of skeleton bone thing, you know, I'm gonna be all about that. And there's a little pack of artist trading cards. Can't go wrong with these, this is great. Oh, a little baby book on the inside, oh my God. The Tale of Benjamin the Bunny, so freaking cute. Oh my God, something else for the bunny shelf. I think I might have to start it. Might have to start a bunny shelf, guys. More really cool tissue. More awesome tissue ephemera stuff. Chunk of like a ledger of some sort with like actual handwriting on it. More ephemera inside. It's like classic sort of sci-fi horror stuff. So you've got like a Frankenstein cut out here. Again, Frankenstein on the inside as well. You have the Invisible Man on the back. So, so cool. Lizbeth, thank you so much for the package. Again, there might have been more in here, but I might have dug through it and pulled some stuff out. So thank you so much for your package. So the next package I got actually over the holidays, and it's from Carolyn, and it came from Australia. So you guys that live on the other side of the world sending me things, I am so grateful. Thank you, because I know the shipping is not cheap on this stuff. And let me try to get to the card first, actually. And it was addressed to Roxanne and James, and it had this really cool like watercolor kind of frog design on the front, super cute. Dear Roxanne and James, just a little token of thanks and affection for all of your wonderful art, fun-filled pug podcasts, blogs, vlogs, and being so generous in sharing your lives. Have a pugalicious festive season. Love, Carolyn from Melbourne, Australia. Thank you so much for such a sweet card and note. I am definitely gonna save this and treasure this. Okay, so on the inside, oh my gosh. Okay, so on the inside, there was some postcards down at the bottom. There was also this little box. Clearly, I ripped into this. I mean, look at it. Oh my God. I'm an animal. Oh my God. Oh, there's goodies inside too. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I forgot. Ah, this is so fun reopening this stuff again. Super, super cute little pug mug, and it says top dog on the inside. That is the freaking cutest thing ever. So stinking cute. And then inside the mug was like a little magnetic pug clip. These super cute little erasers. So there was a whole bunch of little like Halloween erasers on the inside, like a little skeleton and little jack-o'-lanterns and the Scream guy, which are super, super cute. Also inside, these adorable little pug stickers. So freaking cute. And then this pug pin. Look at the pug pin. So much pug swag. And then she sent this. Pig the Fibber. And I had to open it up to see what it was because I had never heard of this before. Look at the design of this pug. It is freaking hilarious. And it's a book. Oh my God, look at his face on the back. I am dying. Look at that face. So it's a children's book and it comes with a little plush. Oh, there's a little pug pen in here too. There's a little adorable pug pen. Pig the pug is crossed out, Fibber. And it's all about, I think, him lying. But it's so funny because it's totally like, this is how pugs are. Like they fart, chasing for treats. That is such a cute idea for a kid's book. And then this was the little plush that came on the inside. Look at his face. Oh my God. Look at the pug rolls. It looks like Lurch. That is the freaking, I'm dead. This is the cutest thing ever. Carolyn, this was way too generous. Thank you so much for this enormous box of pug love. You are amazing. Thank you. I definitely have more to get through. I have more big boxes and envelopes and cards, but I'm a little concerned editing wise because I feel like I've already filmed a lot here. So I'm gonna pause for right now. I hope that in the next vlog I do, I can try to get another mail time portion in there. Thank you so much again, guys, for sending me stuff. I even received a lot of condolence cards for when Bear passed over the summer. And even though I'm not showing those on camera, I just wanna say thank you so much. And what that means for us is just like, it's amazing to get that kind of support and feedback and love from you guys in the mail is just so cool. So thank you for that. Okay, I'm gonna close out the vlog here. I got a lot of work to do. Stay tuned for a Book of Bun tour video kind of thing. I'm working on that. That will probably be the next video that comes up here on YouTube. And hopefully that will have the complete information of when you can order the Book of Bun and when it will be available in my Etsy shop. Don't forget, I'm also over on Twitch. I'm streaming there anywhere from 2 to 3 days a week. So come hang out. And then actually the last Twitch stream that I did yesterday, James and I revealed the Book of Bun zine in its entirety. So you can actually go watch that video if you want. I'll put a link in the description box below and you can watch a full flip through live tour of us unboxing the Book of Bun zine. And there goes James right there. I need to go get some work done. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!